After sealing a return to the Premier League, Fulham manager Slavisa Jokanović set about making some changes and bringing in reinforcements. In the summer transfer window, he brought in just shy of £100 million worth of new faces. They paid £27 million for Nice midfielder Jean-Michel Seri, £15 million for Swansea defender Alfie Mawson, and £18 million to bring back Newcastle's Serbian international Aleksandar Mitrovic to Craven Cottage. Jokanović laid down an early marker to his squad by employing rotation after defeats in their opening two games to Crystal Palace and Tottenham. Despite bringing in two new goalkeepers, Jokanović looks to be reverting back to last season's stopper Marcus Bettinelli, favoured for his greater physicality and long-range distribution. In defence, Fulham operate with a traditional back four of two attack-minded fullbacks and two positionally disciplined central defenders. Timothy Fosu-Mensah, on loan from Manchester United, is at right-back, with highly rated Joe Bryan on the left. Both players are encouraged to get forwards, but in differing styles. Fosu-Mensah is charged with overlapping, using his pace to get to the byline and cut back from there. In contrast, Bryan, who is an established crosser, will look to deliver from deeper and wider areas. Dennis Odoi, who played a key role last season, is partnered with new man Alfie Mawson. As a pair, Odoi is highlighted as the more mobile, and with Fosu-Mensah and Bryan still inexperienced at the highest level, he will look to move across to assist in one-on-one situations. Mawson will look to occupy the box, dealing with the majority of aerial challenges. He will also look to carry the ball out, with Odoi stepping into cover. In midfield, Jokanović has kept faith with Kevin McDonald and club captain Tom Kearney, alongside Seri. McDonald acts as a traditional anchor, deployed in the number 6 role to protect Odoi and Mawson. Although he operates in a fairly rigid role, his passing brief is to break the opposition midfield press with balls to Kearney and Seri as they push forwards. Seri has made a real impact since signing, netting twice already and providing a driving force in midfield. He operates to the right of McDonald, with Kearney on the left in a narrow three. The Ivorian international's main strength is his ball-carrying ability, which he looks to utilise to push opposition midfields back. He also operates alongside McDonald when Fulham are out of possession, looking to exercise a counter-attack when the ball is regained. Kearney is given a freer license in midfield, but he's charged with finding a different method to penetrate the opposition. Jokanović deploys the 27-year-old as an advanced quarterback in their system when Fulham look to create goal-scoring chances. Employed in a narrow left-side midfield berth, Kearney consistently looks to go forwards in his movement and passing. The positions he takes up allow him to operate in space between the midfield and the advanced left-back. This allows him to deliver passes from inverted areas that look to maximise the impact of Mitrovic. Jokanović continues to rotate his front three, with the tactical structure changing based on personnel. Mitrovic is at the heart of the trio, and his movement and strengths are catered for to ensure the best goal return possible. His physical, bustling style is an issue for defenders, but the runs he makes and the movement of his fellow attackers are the real key to how Fulham look to unlock sides. Fulham have dipped into the loan market to bring in former Chelsea man Andre Schürrle and Luciano Vietto. Neither is a specified winger by trade, however, given the battering ram nature of Mitrovic, Jokanović has had to adapt to allow them to have a creative role. Both players preferred a left-sided role to cut inside from, but Vietto has taken a position on the right to accommodate Schürrle. They are, however, comfortable swapping wings. Despite not forcing fullbacks out to the touchline, they will drag them to the corners of the penalty box to attack them in 1v1 situations. Crucially, this opens up additional space for Mitrovic, and from deep, Kearney to exploit. The idea is to create a lopsided attacking diamond, with Kearney at the left-sided base. This creates issues for defence, as central defenders will have to step out to monitor the threat of Kearney, leaving Mitrovic marked by just one player. This is what allows him to make those near-post runs that he thrives on, pulling defenders with him to either score or leave space behind him in the centre of the area. Ryan Sessegnon remains a key player for Fulham, after the 18-year-old impressed with 16 goals from a left-wing position in 2017-18. However, Jokanović has been keen to state that there will be no room for sentiment this season, and after finding it tough in the opening two games, he was left out. He returned for the defeat to Manchester City, but at left-back, in place of Bryan, and he's kept his place since. However, his strength is further forward, and Bryan is likely to come back in, meaning that Sessegnon may have to settle for a substitute role in the coming weeks. With Mitrovic as the focal point, Fulham could be mistaken for something of a one-trick pony in the top flight, but the structure of the midfield cleverly enables fluidity, and their attacking threat will flourish.